winners for final round is 5 schools have been selected. Registration number 11, Kingston International Academy, Ramya and Ms. Archana. We ask you to come forward to pick up a lot. Registration number 7, BMP Day ICSC syllabus course, M. Saranya and Princy Janita. Teachers, come forward. Can you pick up your lot? Team B. Registration number 9. Ida Scudder School, Ms. Jaya, Ms. Jaya, and Lina. Team A. Registration number 4, Desia Metric Higher Secondary School, A. Durga and R. Maitri, teachers Durga and Maitri. They go to Team D. Registration number 6, Vani Vidyalaya CBC syllabus, Sheila and Jagadish. They have only one team left over. Hopefully they go to the Team E. Once again, congratulations to all the teachers who have taken a lot of effort to make this possible and come to the children's final round. Once again, I would like to ask the teachers to introduce themselves. That will be good. Team A.
Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Mrs. Lina from Ida Scudder School.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Jaya Rumi from Ida Scudder School.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Tracy Janita from
BMP Tech School. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Ramya from Kingston International Academy.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Archana from Kingston International Academy.
Good afternoon to everyone. I am Durga, Desia Matriculation.
Team E, you could introduce yourself, sir, with your name and your school.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon to everyone. I am Jagadish from Vani Vidyalaya, Art College.
Good afternoon all. This is Satya Sheila from Vani Vidyalaya CBS.
Hi. So we'll start with the final rounds. Good luck to everyone. There will be 4 rounds. Okay. So the format. These are our quiz masters for the afternoon. First is me, Dr. Subhashis, then Dr. Matthews will come for a round, then Dr. Sajid and Dr. Physics. These are the 4 rounds we'll have. We'll have a visual round, followed by crossroads, followed by who am I, followed by the rapid fire round. Everyone's favorite, I guess. Okay, so we'll start with visual round. Okay. So these are the rules for the visual round. We'll have 2 questions per team. We'll go from team A 2, all the way to Team B. And then we will come back to Team A and all the way to Team B, the Team E. There will be total of 10 questions and each question has 10 points. If you answer directly, you get 10 points. At the same time, there are chips kept in every table. So if I'm asking a question to Team A, Team B to Team E can write their answers on a chip and you have to keep it aside. By the time 20 seconds is over, you can keep it with you. Can you switch off everyone's mic now? Hello. So, everyone knows how to switch on and off their mics? You want to try one last time? Do you have any problem? Our sound engineer will check. Okay. You comfortable, everyone? Okay. Sure. So, when your turn comes, switch on your mic. You have 20 seconds to answer the question. After which, your time is up and the other teams will get chance to show their chips to get 5 points each. And the past points count a lot, so make sure you write for each of the questions. Okay? Alright? There will be 2 additional questions for the people at the back, the audiences, and there are quite some prizes for them also. I've written 12 points, but there are real prizes also for them. Okay? Good luck. Let's start. Okay? Team A. Timers. Your time starts now. Identify this historic place.
That.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, this is, so Team E has answered Andaman. I'll give one last try. Can you identify the place? You're partly correct.
Jail.
What is it called? Then I'll give you, if you can tell that, I'll give you full 5 points. Because that was the point for, it is in Andaman, you're right, it's a jail, correct. The name of the jail, or anything you know associated with the jail that you can tell. It has a Hindi name, very popular Hindi name. No.
So
I'll give you 2.5 points for that, half point for that. The correct answer is, I'll show it to you. It's Cellular Jail. The Hindi name is Kala Pani. There are quite a few movies on it also. So Kala Pani. It's in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay? So Team E gets 2.5 points. Okay. Team B, ready? Your question?
Hiroshima Nagasaki accident.
No, it is wrong. I'll give you a hint. It is in USA. This incident happened in the USA.
Sir?
Time up.
You can write.
Sure. You think? You have already written. Okay. I think none of the participants have given the right answer. I'll give you a hint. This is not a bomb. This is an airship.
In the olden times, airship was filled with hydrogen. This incident is when one of the airship caught on fire because the hydrogen is very flammable. That's the reason. Any idea about now? Anyone can give the answer?
No.
Okay, I'll tell you the answer. The answer is Hindenburg disaster. This light was caught on fire. Now I can hear some gas spin. Yeah, it's a very popular story when chemistry played a huge role in our day-to-day lives. And finally we know not to put hydrogen in our airships. So now all the airship is not used commonly except for only advertisement. And all of those airships are now filled with helium, not hydrogen. Okay, your time starts now. Team C.
Captain of Pakistan.
Right. Right, right. But you have to name.
Babar.
Good.
I complete name, I am not great thing, sir. Babar Zal.
Good, from you will help her. But you are there. What is the sign there?
It's Babar. Yes.
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 Anyone else? Okay. So I'll give her 5 points, half for that. The full name is, because she described the player also. And Team E has got the right answer also, so I'll give Team E 5 points. Okay, because we are already giving Team C half a point. Okay. Okay, Team D, ready? Your question. So there's a World Cup showing what country in the Africa. This country produces a very important mineral. It is very important in battery. Manufacturing. You can either name the country or the mineral. For past question, getting either of the names will carry half point. So past questions, please write both the answers.
Fine. Other teams can write.
Yes,
if you written.
Anyone else? What's your answer? It's not Japan. Want to try at the mineral? What mineral? That is very important in battery production. Okay, none of the teams have got the answer right. This country is Congo, the Republic of Congo, and the mineral is cobalt. I have to answer a little hard question, but what makes it funny is that now that the world is slowly moving to the electric vehicle route, yeah, battery manufacturing is becoming the bottleneck, which is stopping the generation of more and more cars. So we all use lithium-ion battery. One of the key components is cobalt, and throughout the world, only one country has a good supply or deposits of cobalt, which is this country, Congo. And both US and China are fighting over it right now. So this is big news in the recent times regarding the thing. Okay, Team E, find your direct question.
Dolly.
You're right. Congratulations. Do you want to say something about the Correct, that's right. And
nuclear transfer.
Okay. From where was it done? Or what is the significance of Dolly?
Cloning suit.
Correct. So it's the first mammal to be cloned. We have done non-laminate cloning before. This is the first mammal that was done from a somatic cell. And after Dolly also, they have thrown Dolly's progenitors also. And they were also successful. Okay, audience question?
How much marks?
10 marks to EE. Audience questions? Identify the country. There is no additional points for the teams, but they can answer after the audience gets
questions.
Anyone? Peru? Correct, that's the right answer. Do you want to guess what is that picture in the right hand corner? Not Kilimanjaro. You? Peru is right, but she has answered. Can you tell what is that picture in the right hand corner? Sorry? No, no.
Sorry.
Anyone? No, no, no. It is a famous place in Peru. Okay, it is Machu Picchu, correct. So, she gets a prize for the audience question. A round of applause for her. Thank you. Your name?
Annie.
Okay. Congratulations. Okay. So we move over to the second round of five questions, starting from team A, your direct question. This is a modern photo for a old disaster site. Picture is latest, the disaster was in 1980s.
Nuclear power station.
No, you have to be more specific. You're on the right track.
Atomic missile.
No, but you have to name the place. Okay, team has answered.
Right.
Anyone else? Okay, team E has answered correctly. It's Chernobyl disaster site. So, want to elaborate on that? Want to speak on that? What is this? This is a modern day picture of that place. So the Chernobyl reactor, after explosion, they still had fission material which was still emitting radiation. And there was no way to dispose of it. So what they have done is they have taken 10 years to build a dome all over it. So this is called Chernobyl New Safe Confinement, commonly called the Chernobyl Dome. and it took 10 years to build. It is to protect the nuclear fission not to come out and contaminate the neighboring area. Okay, team C, your direct question.
Hyderabad.
You have to identify the monument.
Chandminar.
You are right. 10 points to 10 points to 10 points. I think it was easier out there. Few. Team D, your direct question. It is in Asia, the country is in Asia. Okay. Time out. Team A has got it right. Congratulations, it's Israel. Congratulations to Team A. 5 points to Team A. Okay, it's turn. Your turn. Good. Team E, the last question for this round. Direct question to Team E. He had a very short term in office. But twice. No? Other teams? Anyone wants to try? Welcome, please. Team B, C, D. Team C wants to try? No, he was not that popular. And other teams are caught, right? Sir, yes. Yes. Do you want to elaborate on? Yeah.
Prime Minister.
Correct.
After Jawaharlal Nehru.
Correct.
After Lal Bahadur.
Very good. That's perfect. After what is your name, sir?
Oscar Reddy from BA.
Yes. Congratulations, sir. Very good. So he was Prime Minister twice for a few days only, roughly 1 month each. And so he'll still consider a Prime Minister because in Indian Constitution there's no scope for an acting Prime Minister. He was the Home Minister at both times during Nehru's death and Lal Bahadur Shastri's death. So he became the interim Prime Minister. Okay, audience question. This will require some time. Take out your calculators or any pen, okay? And the first one to answer gets a product price, okay? This is a question. Convert to decimal. Raise your hand, I'll come to you. You want to try, you can try. There's prizes for you also. Who? Tell your name and your school from?
My name from Kingston.
And both of you answered 100? Okay, congratulations. It's correct. Do you want to tell anything about the hint that I have given? There's a small mistake there. Okay, anyway, you have done it, so you know what it is. Basically, the hint was misleading because I have not given the zero position value. So, anyone could have done it differently. Anyway, you both get the prizes. Congrats. Okay, time for round two.
Scores, I need to say.
We'll announce the scores after round one.
At the end of round one, the direct round, Team A scores 5, Team B yet to score, Team C scores 15 points, Team D yet to score, Team E scores 20 points.
Job. You also should participate actively. So we'll move on to the second round. Second round is called Crossroads. And Dr. Matthews will be conducting.
Hi, I would like to explain the rules for this round. So in this round, every team can choose any category of their liking from the categories that we are going to show you after this. And each category will have 2 questions. So each question carries 10 points, but if you answer both correctly, you will get extra 5, so total 25. The opposing teams can always submit their answers, but they will only carry 5 points each. So shall we begin? I'm starting with Team E. You can choose any category from the categories given here.
Health and lifestyle.
Okay, Team E has chosen health and lifestyle. The question to you is, what was the first low-calorie sweetener to be synthesized? Sugar substitute?
Glucose?
No, that's the wrong answer. The other teams can try to answer this question. That's the wrong answer. You've cut off all the sugars, but that's the wrong answer. The question is for sugar substitute. Okay, I'm moving on to the next question. The answer is saccharin. Okay, question to Team E. The deficiency of this vitamin causes problems in blood clotting.
Vitamin B12.
Vitamin K. Okay, fine. I'll give it to Team E. Team E wins 10 points. The next team, B, can choose any category of their liking.
Hemp and lifestyle.
You cannot choose the same category again, sorry. Okay, Team D has chosen mythology. Other teams can note down the answers on a paper instead of answering it directly. So the first question to Team D is, in Indian mythology, says Narada invented the musical instrument. Can you name this musical instrument? No, that's the wrong answer. The other team members can write down. Both Team B and Team C have the right answer, which is Veena. The second question to Team D is, according to Greek mythology, what did Prometheus, the Titan, steal from Mount Olympus and give us to the humans, which was previously in possession only with the gods? What did Prometheus steal from Mount Olympus and give to the humans? the other teams can write the answers down. Okay, time's up. Anyone? The answer is wrong. The right answer is fire. Team C can choose any category of their liking. Geography of India. Geography of India is a category chosen by Team C. Your first question is, what is the highest mountain peak in the Western Ghats? Other teams can write down the answer.
Annamalai.
That is the right answer. The next question for Team C. What is the largest saltwater lake in India?
Seaboard.
Think carefully, you have a chance to win extra 5 points.
It is in Mount Kailash.
Name the lake, please.
Sorry, sir.
No problem. Anyone else with the answers? The answer is Lake Chenika. Moving on to Team B now, you can choose your category.
Current affairs.
Team B has chosen current affairs. And your first question is, when is National Milk Day celebrated? You have 30 seconds. If any other team knows the answer, you can write it down. That's the wrong answer. Can anyone in the audience answer this question? Okay, the right answer is November 26th. And Team D and E have both answered this question. So they get 5 points. Team D and E. Both Team D and E. So the next question to Team B is, the 2021 United Nations Climate Change Conference was conducted in the city of, can you name the city? This also happened very recently. The conference is also known with the name of that city. Other teams can write down the answer. I'm sorry, that's the wrong answer. He has answered New York, which is the wrong answer. Anyone in the audience who can answer this question? Please raise your hand. Okay, I'm sorry, the answer is Glasgow. Going to the next team, Team A, you can choose any category of your liking. Information technology. Team A has chosen information technology. The first question to you is, Facebook recently changed its name to what?
Meta.
That is the right answer. Facebook recently changed its name to Meta. And the second question for you is, what smartphone company in India has the largest market share?
Samsung.
I'm sorry, that's the wrong answer. Any other teams want to try? So both team E and C have the right answer. The answer is Redmi or MI, owned by Xiaomi. So in this round, team E and B have 5 points each, and team A gets 10 points. So I'll ask the remaining questions to the audience. So first category being modern Indian history. Can anyone answer this question? Who was the first Indian woman president to chair the Indian National Congress in 1925 at Kanpur? Please raise your hands. That's the wrong answer. Anyone who knows the answer to this question?
Sarojini.
That is the right answer. What's your name, please?
Nitin Krishna from Born India, CBC.
Congrats. The correct answer is Sarojini Nayudu. And the second question is the name of Gandhiji's ashram.
Sabarmati Ashram.
Could you tell me your name, please?
Maitreyan from Bani.
Congratulations. The correct answer is Sabarmati Ashram. I have two more questions for the audience from the category of literature. So, the first question for you is, who wrote the Panchatantra? That's the right answer, is Vishnu Sharma. Your name, sir, please? The right answer is Vishnu Sharma. And the last question for the audience is, who wrote the poem, The Road Not Taken?
Frost. Yeah,
that's the right answer. The answer is Robert Frost. So this brings us to the end of this round. Could we have the points for this round?
At the end of second round, team A, for the second round, team A scores 10 points. Team B with 5, they've started their scoring. Team C is at 20. Team D, 5. And team E. Total, team E scores 40 points. Team C scores 35 points. Team A scores 15 points. Team B and D scoring 5 points.
I now invite Dr. Charles for the next round.
Good afternoon to all. This is a very simple round and it's only for the teachers. I'll take you to the guidelines about it. So each team gets one round. The question to you cannot be passed. And there will be 4 clues. If you answer the question without clues, you can fill full 50 points. With every clue that you take, you have a decrement of 10 points. So it's only one question for you, it cannot be passed, and prompted answers from the audience will not be
You pass it? Okay. The right answer is Mrs. Paro Anand. Now the next question to Team D. In 1942, a mission from the UK had sought Indian cooperation in the Second World War. Okay. The final. He rejoined the Labour Party in the year 1945. Okay, the right answer is Stafford Cripps, after whom the mission named as Cripps Mission. Now the third question to Team C. Director of Max Planck Institute in Germany for about 2.5 decades. Model. Okay, now for Team B, it's quite an easy answer. She is the recipient of the Padma Bhushan Award for her exemplary work in cancer research and patient care. Now she's a poet. Yeah. Now she's a cancer researcher, but doctor. You want no? It's for team. It cannot be passed. You need a 1 clue. She's born into a family of two Nobel laureates. Two members from her family have awarded the Nobel. X-ray crystallography formed the basis on proposing the helical structure of DNA.
Rosalind Franklin?
No, no, His work was based on this person's work. That is an extension of his practice. Thank you.
The scores remain same. So we have the fourth round where we can develop the scores. So rapid fire round.
Going to the last round for this quiz session, and before starting, I just give a little bit of hint what the question will be. That question are equally distributed among the team. It will be equal. The weightage of the question will be almost equal among the all the teams, and it will be on the current affairs one, or someone would have won some recently in a game, or maybe in some science. A little bit of diabetes and its association, and a general knowledge question. So it will then be 8 questions, and each carries 5 marks, and the time for the each team is 1 minute. And if you are not able to answer a question, you are always welcome to say pass. And if there are time permits, we will be asking the same question again, and there is no pass question for this, and no negative markings. Okay, so I'll start out from team A, so someone can mark it. So the time starts now. Name of the weightlifter who won a medal in Olympics recently in Tokyo.
Sushil. Sushil Kumar.
Pass. You want to pass? What is the capital of Manipur? Wrong answer. What is the capital of Peru?
Silly.
Wrong answer. Expand SARC. SAARC.
Severe acute respiratory syndrome.
Wrong answer. The Nobel Prize for Peace was awarded in 2021 to one of the Diabetes affects hands. Does it affect hands? Is there any effect on hands?
Yes.
Yeah, right answer. Insulin was tried as a nasal route in the past also. Can you give insulin in the, via the nose as per the science?
No.
Wrong answer. It can be. What is the last question is national heritage animal. Anybody wants to try? What's an Indian national heritage animal?
Elephant.
Fantastic. It's Indian elephant. The first question was name of the weightlifter who won a medal in Olympics was Mirabai Chanu, who is from Manipur. And the second question is, who is the capital of Manipur? It's what's the capital of Manipur? It's Imphal. And capital of Peru is Lima. SARC, S-A-R-C. It's South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. It's India is one of the, and Nobel Prize for Peace was won by a couple of people, was Maria and also Dimitri. And the yeah, the one of the answer you told was hand was right, and also the third, seventh question was right. You were, the nasal road you can. So it's 10 points for that. They said to answer. Name of the wrestler who won a medal for India in Olympics, 2020 Tokyo Olympics.
It's my pleasure to introduce a few dignitaries for their function today. I request Professor Nihal to welcome Dr. Prabhakar Moses and introduce him to the audience too.
Good morning.
It's afternoon, so I think you're all feeling hungry and you want to fill your stomachs, right? Okay. So thank you for coming here today. This is our first major event that as an institution, as a department, we're holding for the people of Vellore, and after COVID has come, yeah, reaching out to you. Normally we get a much bigger number than this, maybe about three times the number, but I think obviously the rains have put people off. People are trying to catch up with your studies in school, your curriculum, and so all kinds of factors which are, have kept the number a little low. But anyway, thank you for coming. You're all very enthusiastic and brave people. And I would like to once again emphasize the reason why we're having these programs. You know why we're having these programs for you? To make you more aware about diabetes. And I hope you've learned something about this. We gave a caption today for the painting competition, which was a little unusual, right? And maybe those of you who have painted, congratulations for all the wonderful work you have done and you have contributed. You don't have to win a prize, just taking part is so important. So once again, thank you for that. Now I'd like to have the opportunity and the privilege of introducing our very special chief guest for today. I'd like to introduce Professor Prabhakar Moses to you. Professor, please give him a hand, sir. Professor Prabhakar Moses is a pediatrician, and he was former professor and head of the Department of Pediatrics at Christian Medical College, Vellore. I'm not going to ask you a quiz question. What is the meaning of the word pediatrics, right? Okay, I hope you know that. Right, okay, good, wonderful. So, he is professor of child health and pediatrics, as popularly known, at CMC Vellore. He retired several years ago. But he's now very actively involved with a group called the Wellcome Trust Research Group at CMC Vellore, which does a lot of research work, particularly on diarrhea and diseases which are related to the gut. So he's involved as a clinical researcher in that department. Now, Prabhakar Moses has a very illustrious history. He belongs to the batch of 1968, is that right, sir?
69.
Right, I made him 1 year older than what he was. But he belongs to the batch of 1969. Of CMC Vellore, and then subsequently he's done his post-graduation also in pediatrics over here. And then he worked in the United Kingdom, in Scotland, sir, is that right? For a period of 3 years, gained expertise there and came back over here to India. Now in Scotland he had other talents as well. He played second division cricket in Scotland over there. So that's pretty high up, you know, and he was a good leg spinner. I can see that you're all clean bowled. Right. So after that, he came back to the institution and he joined back to his parent unit, that is Child Health Unit 2. And he was known for his clinical skills. In fact, maybe at least one of the eight of you have been looked after when you were children. Perhaps, maybe, maybe not. But he was a very good pediatrician, a very good clinician. So if you say someone is a good clinician, is that they have very good diagnostic skills. And he was a very meticulous person, very very insistent on good patient care. He used to supervise the postgraduates, teach them a lot. He was very well known for that. He had a broad interest in pediatrics, but also focused on certain other aspects. He wrote chapters in several books in pediatrics as well, and played an important part in the development of pediatrics when it subsequently even started dividing into its subspecialties. So his wife, Mrs. Grace Moses, was a teacher in the College of Nursing. She was involved in teaching English, and she played a wonderful role there as well. So, and his son, Emmanuel, is finished his MBBS and is now awaiting his entry into the postgraduate course. Thank you, sir, for coming again, and we look forward to your address to the audience. Thank you.
So we welcome you, sir, and could you please address the gathering?
My dear school children, teachers and well-wishers, it's indeed an honor for me to be here among you I'd like to congratulate all the participants of this school children's painting competition, as well as the teachers who took part in the quiz. And you know why this year is so important for diabetes 2021, anyone knows? It's a centenary year of the discovery of insulin. It was in the year 1921, Dr. Banting and the best is isolated insulin from pancreas. And the first patient who got the insulin was a 14-year-old boy on June 11, 1922. Now before that, diabetes, the diagnosis of diabetes in children meant a sure and early death. In fact, one of the early observations was those afflicted with this disorder had a painful, disgusting and slow death. And the kidneys and bladder never stopped making water. This is what an observation from one of the ancient physicians about diabetes. And the treatment was what? Starvation and fasting. That was the treatment for diabetes. Now all that changed in 1922 when they discovered insulin. And the story goes, there was a 14-year-old girl in US, her name was Elizabeth Hughes. Her father was a famous politician in the United States. And she developed diabetes at the age of 14. And she was awaiting an early death. And the treatment was starvation treatment. And the weight had decreased to 20 pounds, that is about 40 kilos. She was then started on insulin. And glad to say, she went on to live a normal life. And she died in 1981. At the age of 72. And she married the Ford Car Company's general counsel, and she led a full life. And in fact, she outlived Dr. Banting, who discovered the insulin. Now, you know about our actress Priyanka Chopra's husband, Nick Jonas. Anyone knows his disease? Type 1 diabetes. And he was diagnosed at the age of 15. And he says he was one day away from going into coma. And today he is hale and hearty and has started an organization called Beyond Type 1. Okay, that's the story of diabetes as it is today, the treatment wise. And you know, you are hearing about the claims that diabetes can be cured. You look at the net, you'll say the cure for diabetes. But generally, diabetes is a lifelong and lifestyle disorder. And you have to control it with lifestyle modification. Mainly, you know about all that, diet, exercise, and a proper weight. Okay? And for this, to maintain a proper weight, the lifestyle is very crucial. And what does it mean? You need a proper exercise. Now, the last 1.5 years, you all have been under lockdown, and that has resulted in many children and adults becoming overweight. Now, I'm nearing 70. Though I am not in the pink of health, I do have a reasonable weight, thanks to, because I maintain a proper diet and exercise. And also have a keen interest in sports, which developed at your age. When I was in school in Coimbatore, I developed interest in cricket. In fact, one of the first things I look at the newspaper in the morning is the sports page. So that interest developed from my school years. So I encourage you to all develop interest in sports and other outdoor activities, which will keep you going in the years to come. The International Diabetic Association has chosen as its theme access to diabetic care for the next 2 years. Why is this? Why? Because millions of diabetics in the world do not have access to proper diabetic care. India has 7.5 crore diabetics, second only to China, which has got 11.5 crore diabetics. Now, treatment for diabetes is expensive. Visit to a hospital costs you time, travel and money. The newer models are being developed. They call it the hybrid model, where the technician comes to your house of a diabetic, he takes the blood sample, checks the weight, checks the blood pressure and puts the results online, and you get a teleconsultation with the diabetologist. Now this may reduce the cost, but still there is expense involved. So which is the best way to control diabetes is prevention. So that is what is all this campaign is about. And how do you prevent simple lifestyle changes, proper diet, exercise, and what? Maintaining a proper weight. Okay. I hope you will carry this message and you will practice it. And not only you, please tell your friends and relatives. I'd like to congratulate and appreciate the efforts of Dr. Nihal Thomas and his team for organizing this to spread the awareness of diabetes among school children and the community. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sir, this is too honoring for the moment. Please. And Mr. R. Jodi, congratulations to you. International Academy, Secretary of the Member of the Academy. The third prize goes to Ida Scudder School. The contestants are Ms. Jaya Ruthi Hecki and Ms. Mahar Veena. Participants can please note that the cash awards for these prizes would be awarded in the valedictory function in a couple of months.
I would like, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Arun Paul, who is a professor in the Department of Dental Surgery. He has raised his presence to help us judge the competitions today. He has been working with CMC since 2018. He has done his bachelor's and master's from Raghav Dental College. So I invite you to the stage to please accept a token of appreciation from us. Dr. Nihal, could you please come on stage?
We'd like to invite Mrs. Meena Shekhar as our guest for the day. She's a professor in medical surgical nursing and she has published a number of research articles and an active person as a research person workshop. She's passionate about meeting school children and advocating health awareness programs. Thank you very much, ma'am, for being with us today.
Good morning, children. You all did very well. We could really admire the way how you got prepared yourself. And we could understand your parents, your teachers were at the back, and you all referred books, and you all know brought out that how our country is affected with diabetes, and how important every one of us must know about diabetes and to treat. What is the economic burden on each and every one of the individuals? You all really referred. You gave the judges the tough time. Really, we had to put lots of effort. Dr. Avinash, Dr. Arun, and Meenakshi, we two, three together spared our time. According to the guidelines given by Dr. Nihal Thomas, our professor, and his team, we evaluated. So we looked at the creativity the students brought because it is the painting competition, overall presentations and the content relevant. We looked into your topics, how you are presenting, how neat it is and how deep you have gone through, especially the statistics are brought out, the complications are very well brought out and the contents proved that many students worked towards this competition, and you all took effort. Your participation itself is the good move, and keep it up. With that, we just did our justice. So based on that, two consolation prizes, that is NKM Higher Secondary School, MUK, CMD Jain School, CR Akshita, are getting consolation prizes. The third prize is taken by DAV Bell School, Jaya Pratipa. And the second prize, Snehadeepam School, K. Shruti. One more second prize, SDS School, T. Sweta. The first prize is from Park Higher Secondary School, SKV, Guru Prasha. Children, come forward. Come forward. I thank Dr. Nikhil Thomas, Professor, for this great opportunity for me. I worked with sir. I thank Dr. Felix for recommending me, my friend, as Dr. Felix. Keep it down.
It's my pleasure to thank one and all of you for bringing out your talents here and being with us and cherishing this event. It's a memorable day for us. Despite the odds, you've come here and been with us.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our channel. Press bell button for update videos. Like and comment our videos. Thank you.